In your Bible,
is the word being as
in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 10, verse 46 to
49. Sulla la cumbre posterior, ma come in una sita ad la capitana da tanto.
I'm reading in the name of Jesus.
Attenda tu solo la tica gina da Gesù.
They came to Jericho. As he went out from Jericho, with his disciple and great multitude, the son of Timaeus. Bartimaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the road. When he heard that it is Jesus the Nazarene, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, you son of David, have mercy on me." Many rebuked him that he should be quiet, but he cried out much more, "You son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him." They called the blind man, saying to him, "Jehovah, get up, he is calling you." He cast away his coat, sprang up, and came to Jesus. Jesus asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "Rabboni, that I may receive my sight again." Jesus said to him, "You go your way, your faith has made you well." Immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus in the way. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. This is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Son of the Living God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Bible says, Jesus was going on his way. And as he was walking on his way, a man called Bartimaeus. And that man was sitting by the side of the road.
He
wasn't in the road, but outside of the road. And I would like you to say something to your neighbor. You need to understand this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And tell your neighbor, "Don't wait for your time." Hallelujah.
Amen.
As Christians, we don't obey the time. And as we don't obey the time, we miss many things. Before I continue, I want to tell you this. I like American people. They respect the principle of time. They know the secret that dwell in the time. They know the inconvenience or the problem that follow when you are late. Usually they say time is money. And we know when we have an appointment somewhere or to the doctor. So, even in America, if you call less, they will not welcome you if you are late on your appointment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, that is something very good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then, it's something that we, as Christians, we must understand why. Someone told me last time, they say African hours.
Not too much in Africa.
Congolese hours means you must be late. That is not normal. That is a demonic word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Christian, we must obey the time. Each person, the things called time, we have seconds. We have a minute. We have hours. We have a day. We have a week. And we have a year. A month. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So for that, we need to know how to manage it. Some of us are wasting for our time. We spend our time in our
village.
Wasting your time without 24 hours in a day. That is too much for a Christian. I may ask some people here yesterday what you did.
Jana ulifanya kitu gani?
You may say, I didn't do anything.
Utasema sikufanya kitu.
I was just at home and say,
nilikuwa nyumbani.
I didn't do anything.
Sikufanya kitu.
So that is not good.
Ile haiko nzuri.
We must know how to manage our time.
Tunapaswa kujua jinsi ya kuchunga muda wetu.
The problem is,
shida ni hii.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you and me
ninataka wewe na mimi
to understand this.
Sisikie hiki.
There will be one day.
Kutakuwa siku moja.
Time will be stopped.
Wakati saa zitasimama.
I repeat this.
Acha nirudie.
There will be a moment.
Kutakuwa wakati.
The time
saa
will be stopped.
Zitasimamishwa.
Some of Christians, they don't believe that. They don't believe that the time will be stopped. And they say we have a lot of time. We have a time. We have a time. That's why he can sleep. He can whenever he wants. He
stays
home 24 hours. Without to do anything. Why? Because he thinks he has time. The problem again.
The
time is not good. We don't know. Maybe we may die tomorrow. You think you have the time. Maybe after 1 hour or 2 hours, you may pass away. It's possible. Who told you that you will have a white hair? Who told you? Who told you that you have children in your life? Who told you that you will die old? You need to understand what I want to talk to you today. I want us here who has 75 years. Who has? They are gone. They are not. They died. I want to tell you again this. As you are growing up, and the day of your death is coming, as you are growing up, and the day of your death is
coming,
that's why you need to know you are having a day
of
your time. Many people, they grow. Other people, they don't do anything. That they still young. Why? Because they are wasting for their time. Without doing anything. Another thing, we spend our time. Wasting for our time.
Because
we criticizing people without doing anything. It's when you see, you meet people.
In
became 50 or more. Ask him, what did you do in your life? We have people who knows the importance of the time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Time is the gift that God gives to human
beings.
Some of them are not here. I want the Holy Spirit to take over in this place. Hallelujah! The gift that God gives to human beings. And when God gives the time, there will be a time God will ask us about the time.
He will
question you, I give the time. I gave you the time. What you think? With the time. What did you do in your life? And I give you the time. You must remember that. The time is the gift. The time is the gift. I ask you again a question. Since morning. How did you manage your time? Did you know what was your right time? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters. My brother, my sister.
Bartimaya
was a poor man.
I know masking.
Bartimaya was a blind man.
I saw people.
He did not have the eye.
He suffered
a lot. He could not go to the restaurant by himself. He should meet someone who will accompany him. Only for him to go to the store
and help
himself. You need the help of someone. I want to tell you that God is not
alone.
Even to come on the road, someone needs to carry him. Hallelujah! 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 We are together with the
prophet.
Because the Holy Spirit wants to talk to us. Hallelujah! Before Bartimaya got to us, or to beg a man. Before he went to
ask,
Jesus, when he passed through Jericho, he went to Jerusalem. The destination of Jesus was to Jerusalem.
He
is in Jerusalem. But Jericho was on the road of Jesus. And
Bartimaya
did not know that Jesus
would pass
there. But the Bible says that they taught him about Jesus. When Jesus passed to Jericho, he went to Jerusalem. He went to Jerusalem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now listen this. Bartimaya knew his time.
Bartimaya knew his time.
He said that himself, maybe he said inside of him.
Then he said that
in If I let this Jesus go,
how many of you are going to be able to do it?
When I repeat it,
let me go to the
list. And it says, if you can see mine, says inside of me, let Jesus go where he's going. And says, okay, when you will be back, and then I will tell you to help me. Because right now Jesus is busy with many people. It's good for me to let Jesus go. So that's one thing. When Jesus
wants,
we don't want to be
back.
The problem is in Christian life. Christian, we waste for our time. There is many times God visits you.
And
you know that you have a problem. And you know that things are not going well in your life. And you know that you are sick. And God wants to visit you. And God wants to give you a blessing. And God wants to change your life. And God wants to touch your life. But instead of doing something, you remain someplace. You don't want to move. Look, Bartimaeus was sitting on the road. And he took a decision.
To
say, this is the time. I don't want to rest for my time. I must do something to receive my miracle. I must do something to stop Jesus in the world. I don't know if I can see him another time. I must take this chance. I must touch my time to stop Jesus. Because when I reach Jesus, I will get something important. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But I have a question to each person. My brother and my sister. Why Bartimaeus did shout? He wanted Jesus to hear his voice. Why did Bartimaeus shout? Because he was far from Jesus Christ. Why did Bartimaeus shout? Because he was outside of the road. Bartimaeus, all the time I sit on the road, I spent years and years and nothing happened. And you, my sister, you rest for your time. You don't do anything. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We must wake up as the church. Satan, he knows, doesn't have a time.
Satan
knows he does not have a time. The Bible says, he is roaring as a lion. And he is looking for who he can catch. He knows he does not have a time. But as Christian, we know that we have a time. That's why we don't do anything. I want to tell you before I finish. You don't have enough time to rest. You don't have enough time for you to rest. Time is at your
end.
You must do something. You must shout as
far
as you
can.
You must preach the gospel. Because we don't have enough time. children of God,
what
are you doing at home? It's the time to stand up. And to shout outside, to call people for duties, to call people to worship, to call people, my brother, my sister. We don't have not enough time. Stand up and go outside. What are you doing at all? You don't do anything because you think you have enough time. You think you will do after tomorrow. No, that is to his bullets. Don't say that you do after tomorrow. Don't say I will do next week. That is too late. Let me ask you a question. Since you become a Christian, how many people did you bring to Jesus? How many people did you bring to Jesus? If there is a zero, may you think you have enough time. How many people did you bring to Jesus? This, I told you before I start my message. The time that you are wasting for nothing, the Lord will ask you. I give you my time that you bring. I teach you my word. What you teach. How many people you bring? Since you become a Christian, you say 10 years since I got baptized. 3 years since I got baptized. How many people did you bring to Jesus? We are wasting for time. For nothing. Jesus said this. I came with the wage to pay each person according to his
work.
I came to pay. So what will he pay you? What are you doing, my brother and my sister? My brother, Christian will pray a lot. Let me give you this example. If in your street, in your avenue, okay? If there is even one witchcraft, all of the avenue will
travel.
Just one person. He will do his best to bring people in his walk. Witchcraft, they don't sleep. But Christian will sleep like a dead
man.
Witchcraft, they know they don't have enough time. But Christian, we don't do anything because we think we have enough time. Witchcraft, we don't do anything. We don't do anything.
Who
is a Christian here? Please lift up your hand. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Good job to become a Christian. God bless you. And continue. My question is, how many people did you bring to Jesus? No one looked at me anymore. My friends,
Rafiki,
I want to finish by telling you this. Do whatever you feel you can do. I repeat again. Do whatever you feel you're
going to
do. You must know this. The judgment of God is
coming.
The judgment of God
is coming.
The judgment of God has come. In your apartment, how many people did you visit yesterday for the gospel of Jesus? I want to talk with you. Lift up your hand if you visit even one person. If you
didn't
visit yesterday, 24 hours, if you didn't visit one person, God bless you,
Jeremy.
How many people did you visit? Even one person. Every day you come to church. Every week you came to church. Every month you
came
to church. And the last day, God tells you that go away, depart from me, I never knew you. Please do something. You still have a time. Don't say, I will do after tomorrow. Let us stand up. Father, I bless you for your word. And I say, Father, bless each person who accepts this message. And let this message to have a place in our hearts. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. You are our blessing. You are our love. You are our ways. You are our time. You are everything that we can need. Thank you, Father. For this moment, I pray in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But I hope the Lord will help us. Hallelujah. So this is a good moment. As usually, I would like you to worship even for 1 minute. I don't
know
if the Bible says. Our God is dwelling where His praise is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is dwelling.
So, oh, 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 o
Jesus, 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 Jes